Alright guys, so here we are for round 2 of season 2 for the F1 2013 Career Mode Championship in the Mercedes, if you guys didn't already notice that. So, once again, I will be starting from last place, but I got some mixed reactions from the first video. I'm not too sure whether you guys want to see me starting from the back or qualifying. As it stands, I think we are still fairly quick in this Mercedes, so maybe I'll have to maybe make the setup a little bit worse for this car to slow us down a little bit, because if I do qualify, then that means that the races may potentially be a little bit Sebastian Vettel-like, and I'll be out on my own just a little bit too much, maybe. I don't know. But if I alter the setup a little bit, then maybe it'll make things a little bit more even in regards to my competition. So, in regards to this race, we'll be going on a two-stopper. The game recommended I do a three-stopper, but I'm going to try and do the two-stopper, try something different, and see if it works out. Obviously, the tyre wear on this track is pretty horrible, so it's going to be pretty interesting to see how this all shapes out. So, Malaysia isn't one of my best tracks, to be honest, so we'll see how we go. Melbourne was probably one of my strongest tracks, and that was reflected in the pace that we showed in response to the AI. So my setup is still the standard setup. I'll be sticking with that for this race. So for future races, let me know what you guys want to see in regards to qualifying, in regards to just the whole way this Career Mode Championship is run. So I'll be eager to know what you guys think in regards to the future. So wish me luck as we head out on track. Alright, so here we are on the grid for the Malaysian Grand Prix, round 2 of the F1 2013 Career Mode. There is a slight chance for rain, but it's not going to come until much later in the race. And away we go for round 2 here in Malaysia. Once again, we've got off to a terrible start, but that doesn't matter too much. I don't want to be ranging into turn 1 with a whole bunch of cars around me. I can just cruise into turn 1 nice and easy, just avoid any accidents if there are any. And we'll see how we go after the first corner. Now coming through here, we've managed to take 21st place, and we're probably going to take 20th off of Vandegaard, and we do. Taking a nice flowing run through the second corner, and getting through the first couple of corners. We haven't actually made up that much ground, to be honest, compared to Melbourne, where we were already up in the 10th place, or the top 10. So in terms of this first lap and the amount of cars we need to pass for the rest of this race, we've actually got quite a lot of work to do in front of us. So if you guys didn't notice, the AI going very slow on this first lap, which is very weird. Vandegaard brake checking us there for some unknown reason, but hopefully we can get in front of him as soon as possible, as Gutierrez brakes very slowly there as well. Had to cut the corner a little bit to avoid him, but that was, in my eyes, an illegal overtake, so I'm going to let him back through so that we can just get everything done cleanly, as opposed to Melbourne, where it was a little bit scrappy. So I want to clean up my driving in that aspect of racing. So we're going to go around the outside of Gutierrez here. Hopefully he leaves us a little bit of room, and we get position 18 there. So there we go, a nice clean start to this race. Of course, we have a lot more work to do for the rest of this race. We're still only in 18th place. We've got a lot of slow cars yet to pass. So the sooner we can get in front of those guys, the better, because then they won't hold us up if we are, you know, in front of them. So you won't need to worry about that coming into this final corner. Hopefully we can get up the inside of Charles Peak. Oh yes, we do. I wasn't even expecting that. I was just guessing, but we had a massive lock up there, and that's not going to help our tire wear as we approach the latter stages of this stint. So we'll need to watch out for that. Malaysia is actually pretty tricky for its final two corners in regards to lock up, so I'll need to watch out for that as we go up the inside of Charles Peak into turn 1. You wouldn't expect a Caterham to put up much of a fight compared to a much faster Mercedes, so we probably won't see him for the rest of this race. So now we can focus on getting past Jean-Eric Vergne, who is in fact stuck behind a Williams there. So if we look up the inside there, we will get the place, but that wasn't what I was going to say. I was going to say Sebastian Vettel is leading this race by quite a margin over the rest of this field. He's doing his usual Vettel-esque race where he's pulling away from the rest of the field and just bolting. So hopefully the rest of the AI don't let him get away too much. Otherwise, it's going to be tough for me to catch him, if in fact I do get in front of the rest of the field. But that's a long way ahead in this race. We don't want to be thinking about that too much. We just want to focus on getting past these initial teams, and then we can focus on an attack later on in this race. So, as I said before, Malaysia probably isn't my best track. It's probably one of my worst tracks, to be honest. And so are some of the early tracks in this season, like China, Bahrain. I'm not that good at Spain either, so it's going to be quite a fight early on in this championship to see how far up the grid I can get. So I probably may end up qualifying from, you know, these races onwards as we go up the inside of, was that Grosjean? Yeah, it was Grosjean for P14. So the Lotuses, in fact, aren't doing too well in this race. Though, if the Lotus does have good tyre wear, it will definitely help Grosjean get back further up the field. So, leave a little reminder to, obviously I'm not going to see it in the comments, but it'll be interesting to see where Grosjean ends up at the end of the day with his tyre wear. So hopefully he can be up there at the back end of this race. So here we are on lap 3, getting around Adrian Sutil now, as we have the DRS available to us to use after lap 3. And we've probably got the inside of Maldonado here if we're close enough, and yes we do. That Williams does not have any braking performance. Speaking of that, we're lacking a little bit there as we ran wide through turn 1. So that's not good. We've actually lost the spot to Sutil, so we're going to have to redo that work that we put in for the last lap, just trying to catch these guys and passing them, obviously. So it's going to take a little while to get past these guys again, and all the time that I spend battling with these guys means that, you know, the guys at the front obviously pull away. So the quicker I get in front of these guys, the quicker I can focus on getting on with this race. So Maldonado, he's holding his own fairly well through the middle sector, but that Williams doesn't really have the straight line performance to really pass anyone or defend positions very well. So it's going to be a tough old race for Maldonado, and if we go up the inside there, no, there's not enough room. But Maldonado going very slow through the slow corners as well, so it seems like the Williams is only good through the high speed corners, and that's unfortunate for Maldonado because obviously that's not where you get your overtakes done. It is good for lap time when you're by yourself, but when you're in the pack, it's not going to help you. So will we go up the inside of the penultimate corner here? He sort of leaves the room there. We knock over the bollard there into the path of Maldonado, and we get the move done there for P11. So now it's time to move on to Jenson Button, who has stretched out a little bit of a lead over Maldonado, but we're going to go up the inside of him into the first sector split, and there we go, up the inside and into the points now. So after 6 laps into this race, we're now looking at a points finish so far, but we're not done yet. We're still going to try and elevate ourselves further up the field, and we're going to do that by trying to get around Paul Durester in the Force India, who unfortunately won't be driving for Force India. They both confirmed that their drivers will be Nico Hülkenberg and Sergio Perez. But we get the move done on Durester. We'll see you later, maybe after the paddock or something, although after the race in the paddock, sorry. And now we've caught up to Hülkenberg. Had a massive lockup there, which doesn't help the tyre wear at all. And Durester, I thought I was going to see him after the race, but it turns out I'm going to be continuing to race him here. So I sort of made a fool out of myself, and I'm going to have to get past him as soon as possible. Maybe think about going up the inside into turn 1. Oh, that's tight through there when you're both ranging in through there. You lock up almost sometimes, but we got the move done for P9, and now we've caught up to the back of Hülkenberg, who was going defensive on the inside, broke really early there, and left us enough room to squeeze through. We're going to have the inside for this right-hander here, and we should squeeze through. He's going to be forced out onto the curbs there, and there we go, position 8. So next up is Fernando Alonso, but on lap 12 here, we're going to come in for a new set of tyres. It's time to come in. These tyres are pretty much gone, so I'm going to go on to the prime tyres now, and hopefully you can take these tyres for at least 10, 15, 20 laps. That at least will be the plan. I think the race will be about a 3-stopper, I think. So We'll see how the tyre wear goes on the prime tyres. Of course, however this stint plays out will ultimately show us how the rest of the race is going to go in terms of tyre wear. So hopefully we can get some good tyre wear out of this set of tyres, and we can continue to propel ourselves further up the field as we rejoin the circuit now, right in front of Sutil, who I think was just getting passed by a Williams. I'm not too sure there, but my engineer confirms that there's two stops remaining in this race, and now on lap 15 I've gone purple. I've caught up to the group ahead, who stayed out a couple laps longer. I managed to undercut them by about two laps, and now I've reduced that 5 second margin to nothing. And now we're going to try and go around the outside of our teammate here, Nico Rosberg. He sort of squeezed us out a little bit. I tried to leave as much room as possible, but I went on the grass there, unfortunately. But now I'm going to move on to Fernando Alonso, and I'm not going to muck around here, guys. I just want to get past these guys as soon as possible. Alonso shows the inside. I touch him a little bit, but I'm going to let him back through. I don't want to get some kind of advantage by an illegal overtake, so I'm just going to let him back through there. And now my teammate has got a massive slipstream through there, and I had nowhere to go but into him there. Unfortunately, this is turning into a real old dogfight, and it's getting really scrappy. I had to let my teammate through again, and now we've got the DRS, but hopefully we can get past him as soon as possible. As all this is going on, Sebastian Vettel is getting away. He was right in front of Alonso just there. I'm going to go up the inside of my teammate. I've tagged Alonso. He's gone sideways. I'm trying to straighten him out a little bit. But thankfully, we did not get a penalty there. That was so, so, so lucky. If you think back to Season 1 at Singapore when we touched or squeezed out Fernando Alonso, not even doing anything wrong there, and we got a penalty. But it just shows how weird this game can be sometimes with the penalty system. Some days you get away with it, some days you don't. And now we've got up the inside of our teammate once again, and now hopefully this time we can get past Alonso cleanly, and with the DRS you'd have to think it would be. So getting through there into P6, and now we've caught up to Sebastian Vettel, who does what Nico Hülkenberg does. He hugs the inside, but that really doesn't help him there. It just allows me to soar on through for position 5, and that's been this middle stint of the race. And now I'm coming in for another set of prime tyres, I think. In P5 we've made some good progress in this stint. I think we started off about 9th or something like that, so good to see that we're charging through the field, and if we can continue to do that, we might be on target for maybe a podium position. That's Sergio Perez, who just left his pit box there, so we're about 3 or 4 seconds behind him in terms of time. So you never know, at the end of this stint we might be able to challenge him. So I don't think I managed to get any undercuts on anyone in front of me on this stint, so the kind of gains that I made won't be as evident as the last stint. So it's going to be interesting. I'm going to have to really put in some good laps here, and just really charge through and try and catch Perez here as I go purple on lap 29. Do it in the 139s now, and that's straight away into the 38s as well. So we're really on a charge here. We're starting to catch Perez now, and here we are, lap 31. We've caught up to Perez, and I think that might be another car right in front of him. I'm not too sure. I'm not sure if that's a lap car or not. We'll have to wait and see. But the immediate focus is on getting past Perez, and he's trying to get around a lap car. Yes, it is. It's one of the Toro Rossos. I think that was Daniel Ricciardo. Yes, it was. So that scrappiness has allowed me to get through on Perez, and now I've caught up to Kimi Raikkonen, who wasn't too far up the road. And look at that. That's just an easy pass there. The Lotus doesn't have as much straight line speed as us when we have the DRS. So now, lap 40, we're coming in for our final pit stop of the day. This race has gone like a flash after the first stint, and now we're coming in for our final stint of the race. We've done some undercutting over the course of this race. We're going to have to do another 15 laps on these prime tyres, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem, as we've done about that much length of laps on my previous sets of tyres, so it should be okay. The pit stop is once again a 3.1 second pit stop, and my team there, Mercedes, are looking after me well there, so good to see some nice consistent pit stops. And we rejoin with pretty much no one behind us. There's a few cars a couple seconds up the road, so we can just rejoin into this race without any distractions, which does mean a lot. And I think the cars in front of me were Massa and Webber, but Massa has to stop yet, and Webber is going to stop very soon. So we're going to see as we go up the inside of Vettel from a long way out. He must have had older tyres and he was braking a little bit early, but we snatched up that position, and now we can focus on catching Kimi Raikkonen, who I think might not have stopped yet either. And now on lap 45, I think Massa has just come into the pits. Yes, he has, for his final pit stop. And now lap 50, just a couple laps to go in this race. We've caught up to Mark Webber, and he's getting held up considerably by a Caterham there. That's Charles Peak, and that's allowed me to catch up multiple seconds after he's made his pit stop. So his tyres are fairly fresh. I've got a bit of a momentum going here, and that's just allowed me to catch up onto the back of Webber. I wouldn't really expect this to be happening if you asked me 20 or 30 laps ago. I was well down the field, but once again, just like Melbourne, we're making some awesome progress. But this time it looks like Webber actually has a lot more pace relative to Vettel, who was a bit slow in Melbourne. So I think it might actually be a little bit of a task here to get past Mark Webber, as my tyre wear is a little bit of a factor. But look at the sky there, and the rain is actually coming down now. So with three laps to go, there's actually rain falling. So that's another element that's going to definitely challenge the both of us as we're going for the victory here. And just one lap later, it's getting even heavier. So it's getting to the stage where it's almost time to come in for a set of wet tires, or intermediate tires, sorry. But the grip is starting to fade away a little bit. As long as I can stay with Webber here, that'll be all I need to do. I'm gonna stay out, and now I've lost my curse, so that's brilliant. So that's one overtaking tool I won't be able to use to get past Webber. And now it looks like he's actually stretching away a little bit now, as the rain is definitely starting to affect me and my older tires, and I'm losing the back end like crazy now. And I think that if I stay out, then there's possibly no chance of me winning this race. So you know what, guys, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna YOLO it here. I'm gonna come in for a set of intermediates at the end of this lap and see if this gamble pays off, because I really want to go for the win here. If I'm just gonna go for it, you know, I think it's Ayrton Senna who says you have to be on the right tire at the right time, and the time is for intermediate tires. So I'm gonna do that. Maybe this might work out for us, but I'm just gonna go for it. I just want to win this race. I don't really care about losing points or falling off the podium. If I can have a chance at winning the race, and I'm gonna take it. So it looks like no one else is staying coming into the pits for a set of intermediate tires. So that's actually very interesting. So I'm the only one who's gonna be on this strategy, and you'd have to say, with the rain getting even heavier now, that these guys are gonna be so vulnerable to us. And look at that. Rosberg and Vettel have nothing against me. Their tyres are just not suited to the conditions, and I'm just going to fly past them. So you'd have to say that we're going to catch Vettel and, Webber and Massa at a vast rate or not. So this is going to be very interesting. It's the last lap of the race. Can we catch Massa and Webber? You'd have to say that we're going to lap, you know, at least 10, 15 seconds a lap faster than them. There's only one lap left, so it's going to be interesting to see if I can catch him. It might come down to the very last straight or the very last corner, but it looks like, is that Felipe Massa there? So if that's Massa, I pass him, then I wouldn't have really lost anything, because I was going to finish second anyway if I would have stayed out on the dry tyres. And no, that's not Massa, that's Chilton. He's on the intermediate tyres there, and he's made a good strategy call too. But that was Massa. He was getting passed by Chilton there. How do you feel, Felipe Massa? That's just terrible. But anyway, now the focus shifts to now Mark Webber. He's a couple seconds up the road. He's on the straight there, just 3 or 4 seconds up the road. He's got to negotiate one more corner in this Grand Prix, but he's going to be slipping and sliding like crazy. I'm going to try and push as hard as I can just to catch him, because I'm going to be the one who has all the momentum and all the grip coming into this final corner. He's still a couple of seconds up the road, but if he has poor traction out of this corner, we might be able to catch him. But look at that. Webber, he's actually going slowly. Can we actually catch him coming up to the line? Oh my God, we've won the race.
Take a look past our innocence. Take a step back to yesterday. When life would move slower, we would never grow up. All we knew that love was for when we're older. Anything could happen, secretly imagine. They could never tear us apart, too young to fall. This is